मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघायते गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वंदे श्रीगुरुं दीनतारिणं कृपया क्षमतामपराधिजनं खलु शायुतशक्तसुदीननरं सुपथे परिचालय सर्वदिनं प्रणमामि च माधवदेवपदं वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः नमो महावदान्याय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने गौरत्विषे नमः पञ्चतत्त्वात्मकं कृष्णं भक्तरूपस्वरूपकं भक्तावतारं भक्ताख्यं नमामि भक्तशक्तिकं तप्तकाञ्चनगौराङ्गी राधे वृन्दावनेश्वरि वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये हे कृष्णकरुणासिन्धो दीनबन्धो जगत्पते गोपेशगोपिकान्तराधाकान्त नमोऽस्तु ते भुजे सव्यवेणुं शिरशिशिखिपिच्छं कटितटे दुकूलं नेत्रान्ते सहचरकटाक्षं विदधते सदा श्रीमद्वृन्दावनवसतिलीलापरिचयो जगन्नाथस्वामी नयनपथगामी भवतु मे वंदे नंदव्रजस्त्रीणां पादरेणुमभीक्ष्णशः याशां हरिकथोद्गीतं पुनाति भुवनत्रयं भक्त्या विहीन अपराधलक्षै क्षिप्ताश्च कामादितरंगमध्ये कृपामयी त्वां शरणं प्रपन्न वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणारविन्दं भूमस्वखलितपादानां भूमिरेवयवलम्बनं त्वय्यजातयपराधानां त्वमैव शरणं प्रभु वागीशायस्य वदने लक्ष्मीर्यस्या च वक्ष्यसि यस्यास्ति हृदये संवित्तं नृसिंहमहं भजे श्रीकृष्णचैतन्यप्रभुनित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृन्द हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत् So we were hearing the story of a pigeon. The lesson that the Avadhuta Brahmana learned from the pigeon is that a person who has attachment to material things or to family and over attachment to these things, he will ultimately become distressful. So this is the lesson he has learned. So he narrated the story of a pigeon where he was living with his she pigeon in a forest. They had children and then they took care of the children nicely. One day both of them went to fetch food for the children, and when they came back they saw that the children were bound by a hunter man's net. And then the she pigeon, as soon as she saw the children in such a state, she became very overwhelmed with her attachment and love towards them, and she jumped into the net. And the husband, he was seeing that, oh, my beautiful wife, my most obedient wife and most lovable children, they are all gone now. What will I stay? What will I do here staying alone? What is the use of, you know, living any longer? So he lost his intelligence, and then he also went into the net and he voluntarily submitted himself to the hunter man's trap. So in this way, both the pigeons and the children, they were all stuck in the net. So saying thus, Avadhuta Brahmana, he concluded that those who are overly attached to sex enjoyment, those who are uncontrolled, those who don't have the senses controlled, and those who are, you know, taking care of the dependents with lot of love, care and affection, and with lot of attachment towards them, then ultimately such a person, means a person who is overly involved in sense enjoyment, ultimately that will lead to only frustration. So this is the lesson that he has learned. Then in the last verse, yah prapya manusham lokam mukti dwaram apavritam griheshu khagavat saktasta arudha chutam viduhu. Je purusho vimukto arthat argala rahito mukti dwara swarupa manushya deha lab kuriyao kapoter nai griha dharmai asakta hai panditagan tahake arudha chuto arthat shreyapathe arohan kuriyao patito bolia avagatahan. So here he is telling that that living entity means particularly the humans. If a human, after getting such a wonderful opportunity to get deliverance from material bondage, is telling that anargala rahito, this body is an opportunity to become free from all these bondages, and mukta dwara swarupa manushya deha, and this body, human body, is compared to a body that will allow one to get deliverance. Means this is the entry gate to deliverance. So after getting such a wonderful opportunity of human birth, and which is like an entry for delivery, liberation, one who becomes overly attached to household activities like this pigeon, that person is like, you know, a person who has taken so many stairs in the progress, and ultimately he had fallen down. So that will be the state of such a person. Means he had, after passing through so many births, we have got this human birth, and human birth can be utilized in obtaining the highest eternal welfare, because humans have got the discriminating power. They can think what is good, what is bad, what is eternal, what is non-eternal, what is temporary, what one should seek for and what one should avoid. He has got this intelligence. That is why in this very chapter we heard that after creating the humans, the Lord is telling that I have created the reptiles, those who don't have legs, those who have two legs, those who have four legs, those who have multi-legs. I have created so many creatures. But only after the humans are created, I felt satisfied. Because now they can use the Avadhuta Brahmana is coming. Is when when Uddhava told, after you depart from this world, who will guide us? Where can we get our shelter? So all these days you were there, so we were under good care. But now if you are gone, who will take care of us? Then he told, don't worry, my Srimad Bhagavatam is there. You take care of that. I am leaving behind Srimad Bhagavatam. And then further he goes on to explain that, you see, after creating these humans, after creating all these, I have created humans. Humans have got this intelligence. By utilizing their direct and indirect perception, they can see what can be accepted and what should be rejected. And in that context, he started speaking the Avadhuta Brahmana's story, like how he has seen everything in the right manner and he learnt lessons. So, directly and indirectly, directly Lord is speaking in the Shastras, in the scriptures. He is giving direct instructions. And by directly also perceiving so many things we can understand. And indirectly means, like he is seeing, like Chandra, Surya, Moon, Sun, etc. They were all, by seeing all these things, he is learning lessons. So after getting this human birth, which can be utilized for attaining Supreme Lord, if one is utilizing for sense gratification only, then what will happen? Ultimately, that person will be is telling that after attaining a particular state, falling down from that state. Means in the next birth, again we will become humans. There is no guarantee of this. There is no guarantee of this. That is why the wise Guru Maharaj always used to say this, the Labdhva Sudurlavam verse from Srimad Bhagavatam, that after passing through so many births repeatedly, we have attained this Manushyam, this human birth. This human birth, Arthadam, is very, very meaningful, not for sense enjoyment. You see, if we are not learning whatever is happening in the current world also, we are seeing today also, the situation is, you know, everyone is in a lockdown situation. Even now, if we don't understand the urgency of this, any time we may come in contact with that virus, anything can happen any time. But still we are thinking that we are in a safe place. This is the pitiful situation of all of us. Any time, a true person will see that next moment death is going to come. Turnam yateta napateta namrityu yavan. At every moment actually we are dying. But if we are not able to realize it, death comes in such a manner. You know, so many persons are dying, so many persons are getting infected. But still we think that, oh, we are in a safe place and nothing will happen to us. So we are not even learning from the situations. So how good are we than an animal? We are no better than an animal. He is just like no purpose. He does not know what is the purpose of his living. And we also don't know what is the purpose of our living. Isn't it? A dog, cat, animal, he does not know what is the purpose. He thinks that only filling up the belly and taking care of the sense urges, I'm done. Sleeping for some time, finished. That is what is the objective for the day. Today is finished, my objective is finished. Tomorrow, again the same objective, eating, sleeping and sexual enjoyment. Finished. And third day. And we are also same. Okay, one day passed, second day passed. But are we really thinking that tomorrow death is there, next moment death is there? If we are not thinking, then we cannot become serious in Krishna bhajan. We will become serious only when we understand the emergency of the situation. If we can't understand the emergency of the situation, seriousness will not come in us. Krishna, the Lord, the devotees, are trying all their means to bring that emergency in us. That now you wake up. He is giving so many wake-up calls. But still we are putting down the alarm and sleeping, no problem. Next ring I will wake up. Next ring I will wake up. How many times death will ultimately come and devour us? Anumritya yavan. Because at every moment death is coming and gulping us. And nishreyashaya. What one should do before the next death comes again, means immediately, nishreyashaya, one should endeavor for shreyamarga. Shreyamarga means eternal welfare, the path of eternal welfare. One should take the path of eternal welfare. See, even now, people, they are not worried. They are not thinking about, you know, let us do bhajan. Let us utilize this time at least. Now there is no material life. Now there is nothing to work. Let us use this time. How many of us are there serious in this? Including me, I am talking about myself also. None of us are serious about it. Okay, today day is gone, no problem. Tomorrow will come. Day after tomorrow will come. They keep on going. But that seriousness is not coming in us. When will that come? We have sadhus. We have got the opportunity. We have the scriptures. We have got Gurudev. But still we are not serious about this, then it is. Srila Prabhupada used to use the word Prapta Ratna Haraya Deva. You have got a beautiful gem in your hands, but you have not understood the use of or the value of it. And then you just uselessly wasted it. It's a beautiful gem, the priceless gem that you have got in your hands, but because you have no experience of it, you have not known the gem, you have left it. So, after getting this human birth, after getting the association of Sadguru, after getting association of the saints and the scriptures, still we are not alert to the situation. if we are not understanding the preciousness of this human birth, and simply, and not only human birth, Nimi is telling that Durlabham Manusham Deho Dehinam Kshanabanguraha. This human birth is very, very rare. And Dehinam Kshanabanguraha. And it is, even though it is attained after a long wait, Kshanabangura. Kshanabangur means temporary, fickle, any moment it may go. Tatrapi Durlabham Manye, and even more difficult, rare, is Vaikuntha Priyadarsh, to get the darshan of a sadhu, a pure devotee. So we have got both. We have got this rare human birth, and we have got the darshan of a pure devotee. Both the rare opportunities we have got. In spite of that, if the wake-up call does not come in us, then we can be no better than animals. So here is telling that Arudachyato. Arudachyato means those who have ascended, he has fallen down. So we have ascended to this human birth, but we have fallen down from that situation. Bulya avagatahan. Srila Prabhupada writes in the commentary, Itara prani apekha manusher nitya mangal lab koribar adhikatar adhikar ache. When compared to other living beings, humans have got the capacity to attain eternal welfare. Like the other creatures, they cannot perform bhajan. When the pure devotees, they perform bhajan on the streets, they hear those chanting of the Mahamantra, when those that enters into their ears, then they will get benefited. Or maybe some causeless mercy by Supreme Lord, they will get delivered. But humans, they can endeavor for their eternal welfare. They can think about their eternal welfare and endeavor for it, because they have got the capacity, they have got the eligibility. Pashupakhi prabhito hina buddhi jeev. So the animals and the birds, their intelligence is very insignificant. They are not very intelligent human beings. Intelligent means, who is intelligent? A person who learns from his past experiences. A person who learns from his past misdeeds. Oh, that was a mistake, I should correct. An animal does not think like this. A dog, he comes and sits in front of a house, and the person in the house is always chasing the dog away. Isn't it? But still the next day he comes to the same house. Doesn't he? We are chasing down the dog, we are chasing away the dogs from here. But every day they come back here. Why? They cannot think. They're simply, you know, run by their own senses, run by their own, need for the food. That's it. But humans, we understand, oh, this is a mistake I have done. He doesn't like me. Why should I go there? Or this, you know, this person is, you know, always complaining against me. Therefore, I should not go to that place. We have that knowledge. That is why dharmohi tesham adhiko vishesha. The difference between animals and living being is that the dharma, religion. Whereas animals, they have not got such intelligence to follow dharma. Any rules or regulations or devotion, nothing they can follow. Therefore, they are less intelligent. They have intelligence to how to fulfill their belly, how to enjoy, how to sleep. They have intelligence in this. They are called animalistic instincts. They are happy in that, and they have intelligence for that, more than a human has got. But if we also use our intelligence for the same purpose, then we are only called as a two-legged animal. They are four-legged and we are two-legged. That is the only difference. Shastras say like that, you are a two-legged animal. You know, because in Shastras also there are chastisements. You know, we also speak, you know, chastising words, right? The Shastras all chastise us. Like, you are a donkey, you are a two-legged animal, you are a fool. So Shastras chastisement is like this. Tahara stri putrer asakti parityag korite samarto hoy na boliyai manaver drishtite lakshito hoy. কিন্তু যে সকল মানব দুঃখময় সংসারে পরিণাম বুঝতে পারেন না তাহারাই যোশিত সঙ্গ নিরত হইয়া কপোত পরিবারের ন্যায় জড় সংসারে আসক্ত হইয়া পড়ে। সো উই সি দ্যাট অ্যানিমলস হ্যাভ অ্যাটাচমেন্ট টু ইউ নো দের ওন কিথ অ্যান্ড কিন, দে হ্যাভ দের ওন ওয়াইভস অ্যান্ড হাজব্যান্ডস, ইউ নো দ্য মেল ফিমেল দে হ্যাভ অ্যাটাচমেন্ট, অ্যান্ড সিমিলারলি the living and the human beings also, if they don't understand that, you know, having such attachment to the family, such attachment to the children and to others will only lead to unhappiness, those who don't understand this, because you see, this is the experience. Prahlad Maharaj has called it as punah punah charvita charvananam, chewing that which has already been chewed. In this material world, everyone knows that, you know, this is the cycle. Person gets birth, he grows, he studies, he goes to college, and then he takes a job, he gets married, he has children, then he has his own family, then he gives birth to children, he takes care of the children, he gets the children married, and because of doing all these things, he gets attached, and finally, in that attachment, he dies. This is the cycle. Everyone knows this. But still, they follow the same cycle. No one wants to understand that my seniors have tried, my forefathers have tried, my fathers have tried, everyone has tried, in search of the happiness. Rather than getting happiness, they started to look in miniature happinesses that are getting in between distresses. In between distress there is happiness, they are thinking, oh, this is happy, okay. We know, everyone knows, but still everyone is caught up in this cycle. So he's telling that is why he says, punah punah charvita charvananam, whatever has been chewed, and the essence of it is taken out, but still we are trying to chew, and okay, I will get some essence out of it. Just like a sugar cane, you know, its sugar cane is put under the crusher, and the juice has come out. Now if someone wants to eat the pulp and see whether it is sweet or not, will he feel sweetness? The essence is taken out. In a similar way, in this material world also, there is no essence. But that which has no essence, we are trying to find out if there is some sweetness in this. But actually, there is no sweetness. So that is why, Taharai Yoshit Sang Nirat Hoya, Kapota Parivaranai Jada Sansare Asakta Hoya Pade. Those living beings who are overly attached to material kind of living because of uncontrolled senses, oh, excessive attachment to the desires of the sense organs, what they do? They resemble the family of this pigeon. Just like the pigeon, ultimately, dukkha prada, only misery. Here, the attachment to material things is being condemned. But if one has attachment to the Supreme Lord Sri Krishna, if the family, if the center is Krishna in the family, then that is not condemned here. What is condemned is to have attachment to the material relationships. But if a family is run with Krishna as center, then it is acceptable. So, জীবন থাকিতে থাকিতে মনুষ্য অষ্টপ্রকার গুরুর নিকট যে সকল শিক্ষণীয় বিষয় আছে তাহা সংগ্রহ করিয়া নিজ মঙ্গল লাভ করিতে পারেন। সো হোয়াট হিউম্যান্স ক্যান ডু, হোয়াট আদার অ্যানিমালস ক্যানট ডু, অ্যান্ড হোয়াট হিউম্যান্স ক্যান ডু ইজ দে ক্যান সি দিস এইট কাইন্ডস অফ গুরুস উই হ্যাভ লার্নড সো ফার, এইট কাইন্ডস অফ গুরুস ইজ ইট দ্য five material elements, sun, moon, and the pigeon. These are the eight we have learned so far. So he is telling that while living, a human being can see the life of these, by seeing these, he can make them as their guru. Whereas an animal cannot. By seeing water, can an animal think, oh, I can learn some lesson out of this? No. Humans can think. But if we are also not thinking, what lesson can I learn from this water? What lesson can I learn from this pigeon? What lesson can I learn from others? Pigeon means others. We are seeing so many persons like this, getting attached, trapped, and finally in misery. Isn't it? We may not have seen the pigeon, but we have seen so many pigeons like this in our life. They are getting attached. They are dying. They are, while in that state, they are in trouble. And after that state also, they are in trouble. But seeing this also, if they are not learning, then they have not utilized their human birth at all. That is why yesterday, as we heard, Ahani ahani bhutani gacchanti avamandiram. Day and night, every second, people are dying. Those who are senior to me, those who are my age, those who are junior to me, they are dying. Seshastiritam icchanti. But those who are living, they think that, oh, I am safe. I am going to live. Let me make a 5-year plan. Let me make a 10-year plan. What I am going to become after 20 years. We are making plans, isn't it? After 10 years, I want to become this. When I gave interview for the companies, the first question is, what do you want to become after 5 years? And if you have to be very wise in saying that I want to become the chairman of this company. Oh, you are very, very ambitious. So you are eligible for this job. But if you say that I can, whether I will be seeing my next moment or not, I don't know. Get out. You are not eligible for this job. So the more, the better you can present yourself that you are over ambitious and over greedy in this material world, you are called smart. Otherwise, you are a dullard. This is the definition of this world. But Srimad Bhagavatam gives just the opposite. Don't plan for tomorrow, plan for now. Think that you are dying next moment, chant now. Better be a dullard in material terms, but become smart in spiritual ways. That, in Bhagavad Gita, the Lord says, that which is night for ordinary living persons is a day for sadhus. And that which is day for sadhus, or that which is day for the other living entities, is night for sadhus. Means what? Where the living entities are not interested, to which they are very lazy, and to which they are sleeping, that is spiritual awakening. Towards that, the sadhu is awake. That is like day for him. That which is day for the asadhus means they are ready for material enjoyment, this, there, that is their life. There, that is night for sadhu. He has no interest there. So, sadhu's life is completely opposite to the asadhu's life. Completely opposite. If they think about what will happen after 5 years, we will think that what is going to happen now, next moment. Forget 5 years. What is going to happen next moment? Let us be ready for that. That is why, you know, I usually say, we have one person who says art of living, but Gaudiya Math says art of dying, how to die. We don't want to learn how to live. We want to learn how to die. That death is better, in which there is remembrance of the Supreme Lord. Living nicely without remembrance of Lord is useless. But that death where there is remembrance of Supreme Lord is to be hankered after. Therefore, he is telling that by seeing these 8 things, if a human have not learnt any lesson, then what value is that of human birth? Taha sangraha kuriya nija mangal lab kurite paren. So humans, because of having intelligence, discriminating power, they can learn these lessons from these 8 gurus. Everyone is a guru here. Guru means what? From where we learn a lesson. Guru does not necessarily mean a saffron cloth, tridandi sannyasi. A guru means a source from where we can learn knowledge. And if we have that vision, we can see everyone as guru. Prithvi, Vayu, Akash, Jal, Agni, Chandra, Surya, O Kapot. Ei Atti Padarther Bahi Pragya Chalita Darshan Baddha Jiver Indriya Pipasa Samvardhan Kore. Kintu Sutikshna Antarnihita Drishti Tahadike Bhogya Gyan Koribar Parivarte Guruyogya Gyan Korile Krishna Mukta Buddhi Paya Sansare Avasthan Kalevu Mukta Hoibar Adhikar Pradhan Kore. But if one sees these eight elements as an object of enjoyment, oh, water, oh, I want to drink water, very nice, I will make sharbat out of it and drink. If you want to enjoy, you see, oh, this is a source of enjoyment, with this I can prepare lemon juice, with this I can prepare some other sharbat and drink, and this is the summer time, you will become deprived of the lesson that water is giving. Oh, fire, I can cook nice vegetables or I can do this. If you see them only as an object of enjoyment, yes, this is there so that I can fill my belly. You are seeing moon, oh, such a nice moon, you know. By seeing this moon, I am remembered of my lover. Or by seeing the sun, you know, I can get vitamin D. I will sit in the morning, I'll get vitamin D. So we know how to exploit. So if that is the vision we have, then what lessons we'll learn? We'll learn more and more how to exploit them only. Our Gurudev, he used to say, in summers particularly, when he used to come out of his room, very hot in the summers. Now hot summer hasn't started. May is going to be hot summer. So it's particularly in eastern zone, because of the humidity also, very difficult to stay in the summer. Guru Maharaj used to come out of his room and every day he would say, don't become unhappy by seeing the sun. Now he is very fiery, very hot. Don't become unhappy by seeing the sun. You have to pray to sun god. Of sun god, isn't it? You sit in the sun, you pray to sun god that, you know, because you want to fight against the cold. So don't become unhappy or don't become, you know, restless by seeing the sun's heat. You have to pray, sun is protecting us. This is the vision. This is the vision of the pure devotees. Whereas, oh, summers are very bad, let me go to cold place or summer, whatever, you know, because we want to exploit. We only want sense enjoyment, nothing else. If our senses are happy, then we are happy. So, he is saying, such a person cannot extract knowledge or he cannot make them as guru. Because they have tendency to exploit. How can, you know, if one has a tendency to exploit or enjoy, how can he learn any lesson from him or her? Isn't it? We cannot. So, he's telling that instead of making them as an object of enjoyment, if he can see them as sources of knowledge, then Krishnonmukhata Vriddhi Paya, then he will become more and more inclined towards Krishna. Because you are seeing what kind of lesson I can learn from them, then your inclination to Krishna will increase. And sansare avasthan kalevu mukta hoivar adhikar pradhan kore. This human birth, he is telling about the significance of this human birth. That even while living in this material world, he can get liberated. Means he can stay completely aloof from all these things. Even amidst troubles, he is untouched, unmoved. Because he is seeing everything as Lord's arrangement. Tatte anukampam. Everything is Lord's arrangement. If one has the capacity to see that way, then there is no unhappiness at all. If you can see everyone as guru, there is no trouble. So, just a recapitulation of what we have heard. Prithvi, from earth, what did he learn? How to be tolerant. From wind? Anasakta. Not to become attached. Wind is carrying the aroma, bad aroma, good aroma, but he himself is not attached by it. From the sky, what lesson he learned from the sky? From the sky, what lesson is learned? Forgot. Just like the sky is not limited to the you know container that it is put in. It seems to be inside, but actually it is there everywhere. In a similar way, yogis see that even though Paramatma is inside the heart, he sees that the Paramatma, Antaryami, is there everywhere. He is not just limited. Antaryami is everywhere. From the sky he learned this lesson. From water? Yes. Like sadhu, the qualities of a sadhu, very purifying. As soon as one sees or one touches the water, immediately one is purified, and the beautiful sounds that come out of the waves of the water, very, you know, sweet. The words of the sadhus are always sweet. His sight, his touch, his sound, everything is purifying, just like the water. From Agni, from fire?
Digest everything?
Yes.
Does not keep.
Yes, yes. The fire, whatever is offered, even if there is a contaminant in it, he will not be touched by the contamination. He will still remain aloof from that contamination. And just like whatever is offered to the fire, he immediately consumes. He will not store for another day. He will not accumulate. In a similar way, sadhu has the capacity to digest everything. Whatever is offered to him, even if it is a contaminant, even if it is a non-eatable object, he is not touched by the contamination of it, and he will not store it for another day. Chandra, from moon? Moon, like it is changing, waxing and waning moon. Every day it's dwindling and then expanding. For the first 15 days it is glowing, and then for the next 15 days it is slowly waning. So even though the body keeps on changing its phases, the Atma that is sitting inside, he does not change. He remains the same. This is what he learned from the moon. From sun? Yes. Gives back. So he takes water from the earth and then he gives it back to the earth. He will not keep anything for himself. So the sadhus, they are, whatever is offered to a sadhu, he does not become an enjoyer of that object, but he again distributes it among all the needy living beings. And pigeon, we heard very vividly, so everyone knows that with over-attachment to family, over-concern, over-care to anything will ultimately lead to frustration. Iti Srimad Bhagavate Ekadasha Skande Saptama Adhyayer Vivritti Samapta. Acha, Skande Saptama Adhyaya. Adhyaya. So thus ends the 7th chapter from the... Shall we start the next chapter or we have time? So we will start chapter number 8. Shri Brahman Uvacha. Sukham Aindriyakam Rajan, Aindriyakam Rajan, Swarge Naraka Evacha, Dehinam Yad Yatha Dukham, Tan Tasman Necheta Tad Buddha. Our Guru Maharaj often used to say this. Shri Brahmana Bolilan, Hey Rajan, Swarga evang narake praniganer dukkha jerupo ayachita bhave upasthita hai. Indriya janno sukhau tadrupo ayachita bhavei upasthita hai bolia. Viveki monosh purush tadrisha sukher janno kono rupa prayas vikar korena. Telling, Hey Rajan, the Avadhuta Brahmana is telling, my dear king, whether you are in heaven or in the hell, even if you don't ask for misery, it comes, isn't it? Even if you don't ask for a misery, it still comes at your doorsteps, isn't it? The epidemic now we have, Corona, has anyone prayed for it? Please, Lord, we are living happily, please give something to disturb us. Anyone prayed? No one. He is telling that even without asking for it, even without praying for it, distress comes automatically. Indrijan sukhevu tadrup ayachita bhave upasthita hai. In a similar way, happiness also comes even without asking for it. When without invitation, distress is coming, even without invitation, happiness also comes. Therefore, Viveki Purush, a person who is intelligent, he will not over-endeavor to get happiness. So, are we intelligent or not? We are always endeavoring for happiness, to drive away misery and to bring happiness home. All our endeavors are only for this. But here he is telling that an intelligent person does not do this. Why? Because distress is coming without asking for it, without praying for it. In a similar way, if we are destined to get happiness, it will also come. Whatever is destined for, we will get it without asking for it. So therefore, an intelligent person does not waste his time uselessly. What is to be done is to be done. I am a human being. I have to utilize this time for service of Supreme Lord Shri Krishna, not for happiness. If it is destined, it will automatically come. Even if you pray for it, it may not come. We are hankering for happiness, but it may not come unless it is, you know, not destined for us. We are not praying for distress, but it is coming to our doorsteps. So he is telling, therefore, a person, a wise person, never endeavors for, you know, happiness. The only duty of a living being is to perform Hari Bhajan. That is his only objective. That is the purpose of awarding human birth to him. If he does anything other than that, he is simply wasting his time uselessly, not understanding the importance of this valuable and precious human birth. So he is telling, just like distress comes, happiness also comes automatically. Therefore, wise does not endeavor for it. Vishnu Chakruti Thakur writes, ये अष्टमध्याये अजगर आदि नौजन गुरुर कथा वर्णित हुई आचे. So in this particular chapter, nine more gurus are mentioned. So in the previous one we have heard 8. So in this we are going to hear 9 more gurus that Avadhuta Brahmana has learnt lessons from. So that makes it 17. So that remains 7 more. So that will be in the probably in the next chapter. So total he had 24 gurus. And now we are in this chapter we are going to listen about 9 gurus. Tanmadhye pingalar kothai nairashyai sukaprado iha bola hoyache. And in this we are going to also hear about the story of Pingala, a prostitute by the name Pingala. What lesson he has learned from that prostitute, that also we are going to hear in this particular chapter. Nija dehayatra nirbhayer janno atishay chesta kora uchit nai. It is not advisable for anyone to over endeavor to get happiness in this material world. Ei bishaye ajgare guru charity shlok dwara bolite chan. Jemon dukha na chahileu asya pade sei rup sukhau na chahileu asbei. बोल रहे हैं ये जो आने वाला जो ओ सॉरी आई एम स्पीकिंग इन हिंदी ना. सो फ्रॉम वेयर डिड आई स्टार्ट इन हिंदी ओनली दिस सेंटेंस
आने वाला दिन.
ओके ओके द प्रीवियस वन आई स्पोक इन इंग्लिश राइट. ओके ओके सो in this matter, about the python or the cobra, a particular kind of a serpent, is being mentioned. In the next four verses, this lesson from the cobra or the python is going to be mentioned. That is, that the lesson that one has to learn is, Dukh na chaileu asya pode. Even if one does not ask for distress, it comes. In a similar way, Sukh na chaileu asbehi. In a similar way, even if we don't ask for happiness, it will also come automatically. Whatever one is destined to, that will happen automatically. Ihar janno cheshta kora ki prayojan. What is the use of endeavoring for that we are already destined to get? What is there any intelligence in wasting our time? You know that by, you know, this time you are going to get so much money. If anybody knows that by end of month I am going to get $50,000 or pounds or euros or rupees, whatever it is, then will he work in the company? No, nobody works, because the purpose of working is already solved, to earn money. So if he knows that he is going to get money, then nobody will take up the job. On the other hand, if you were to know that even after you work for 1 month, you are not going to be paid in the company, will he take the job? No. Why? There is no use of doing it. So if you are aware of what you are destined to get, what is there in your store, what is the purpose of endeavoring for it? Endeavor for which we are supposed to endeavor for. That is the story. We are supposed to endeavor for supreme welfare. This human birth should be utilized for that. In the previous chapter we heard, the last verse Prabhupada is saying, this said that this human birth is like a gate for the entry to liberation. We are standing at the gate of liberation. But now, rather than entering into the path of liberation, we are tripping down back into this material world. And also in another place it is said that this human body is like a boat to cross this ocean of material world. This body is like a boat to cross the material world. But if that boat is not utilized properly to cross the thing, then it is wasted. So there is no use of endeavoring for material things. Baddha jeev bhoge pramatt hoya nashwar padarthir dwara sviya indriya sukha akankha kore. The conditioned soul, maddened by material sense enjoyments, is always hankering for material pleasures. In order to get material pleasures, he is always running after temporary things. He is running after the temporary things to get his senses fulfilled. Why? Maddened by sense gratificatory desires. Sei sukh dvivido aihiko o amushmiko. He's telling that happiness that living entities are running after is of two types. One is while living in this world, and the other one that is to come. Means that which will come in the future and now in the current thing. These are the two kinds of happinesses. Jivaddashai baddha jiver aihika indriya sukh evang jivitottar kale bhogabasana sthale phale sat karmi ganer swargalab o asat karmi ganer narakadi dukhalab gate. So one is the happiness while living in this material world, and the other happiness is that by performance of good activities in the future birth, if we are, let's say, born in the heavenly planets or some other planets, we get happiness. Or if we have performed bad activities, we will get hellish planets, there we will get unhappiness. So whatever happiness or distress that is there currently, and whatever happiness or distress that we are going to get in the future, these are the two. One present and another in the future. Past is gone. Nobody remembers. But we are performing activities either to get happiness now or in the future, isn't it? We are working for today or for tomorrow. past, nobody, I have to work for yesterday's happiness. Anyone does it? Mm-hmm. Nobody is going to get happiness or distress about yesterday's thing. So in a similar way, two types of, everyone is looking for happiness while living in this world currently, and after death occurs and he takes the next birth, how will he get happiness? For that, he is directing all his activities. He performs good activities, he will get heaven, therefore I can enjoy, therefore he will perform dharma. And if he does bad activities, he will go to hellish planets. But nobody is directing towards Supreme Lord, which is permanent happiness. Everyone is endeavoring for happiness for now or for the future. I often say, in our India, there are so many, you know, persons worshipping the Lord in different moods and ways. And one person has written Kirtan, Aarti Kirtan, they sing everywhere in India. You might also have heard. That is, Sukha Sampati Gar Aave, Kasht Mite Tanuka, Om Jai Jagadish Hare. You heard this song? All of you might have heard this. Everywhere in Aarti they sing this. There he is saying that Sukha Sampati Gar Aave, let wealth come to my house, let happiness come to my house, let my distresses of the body go away. Oh Jagadish, oh Supreme Lord, I worship you. What is the purpose of my worshipping you? Let happiness come to me, let wealth come to me, let my distress go away. I will perform your bhajan, I will perform your worship. So what is this? Everyone is only doing for this. Now, if anybody is doing puja in the house or anything, only let my family be unaffected with coronavirus. Everyone is praying only this. Let my family be unaffected with coronavirus. Now everyone will remember Lord. That is why Kunti Devi says, Vipada Santuta Saswat. Kunti Devi is saying, oh Lord, give distress. Give distress to us. Why? Wherever there is distress, Tatra Tatra Jagat Guru, wherever there is distress, we have seen your appearance. Bhavato Darshanam Yatsyat, when I have seen you, Apunar Bhava Darshanam, I will not see repeated birth and death again. Kunti Devi is saying, my children, my Pandavas are repeatedly troubled by the Kauravas. They are repeatedly troubled. And whenever they were in trouble, oh my Lord, you appeared. Therefore, I pray that troubles come to me and to Pandavas. When the Lord, after Kurukshetra war was finished, he told, now my duty is done, I am going back to Dwarka. Now Yudhishthir will rule the kingdom, I am done with it, he is going. Then Kunti Devi prayed, my dear Krishna, please don't go. Now that all the problems are solved, you are leaving. But I pray that you give more problems to us. Does anyone pray like that? Has anyone guts to pray like that? Nobody has that, you know, courage to pray. That give me only trouble, give me only trouble. Why? She is telling, whenever there is trouble, I got your remembrance. And remembering you means what? I don't have to get attached in this material world. Therefore, that trouble is very, very pleasing, which becomes a cause of deliverance. But people now means every time, they only want to get immediate things solved. Now, I don't want happiness. Everyone is doing puja or whatever, if at all they are doing. They are only praying that let this virus not affect our family. Let the entire world be lost, no problem, but my family should be safe. This is the prayers. But that is not the way of approaching. We have to use this material, this human birth, only for permanent happiness, not happiness in this birth and in the next birth. Why are we so short-sighted persons? Isn't it? We are so short-sighted that we are only working for happiness today and tomorrow, or this birth and next birth. The Lord is telling, the devotees are telling, the sadhus are telling, why are you so short-sighted? Why are you thinking about only immediate future? Think about eternity. think about your permanent happiness, not just one or two or three lifetimes. You are not wise if you are thinking about only short-lived happiness. Buddhiman Bhagavat Sevonmukha Manav Karmakande Nirato Ba Anyabilashi Hoya Indriya Parayan Hoivar Parivarte Indriya Samuher Gati O Akmatra Chalak Bhagavan Kamadev Vishnu Ei Bujite Ei Buddhite Tahar Sevai Nyukta Hoya Kono Prakar Asad Vicharer Anugaman Korana. But the intelligent devotees, means devotees who are intelligent, devotees are always intelligent. Those persons, they don't get attached in the karmakanda activities. Karmakanda activities means those activities by which one remains happy now and in the upcoming birth, in the next birth, immediate birth. So the devotees who are wise, they don't become engrossed in such activities which will give happiness only in the next birth, upcoming birth. But on the contrary, Indriya Samuher Gati O Akmatra Chalak Bhagavan Kamade Vishnu E Bujite. You will understand that the object of our senses is only to please Supreme Lord. The senses will be getting their purpose solved only if Lord is pleased. Just like if the eyes are not utilized in the service of Supreme Lord, to take sight of Supreme Lord, Sri Krishna's deity, then those eyes are useless. What is the purpose of those eyes? In Bhagavatam it says, what is the purpose of those eyes which do not take darshan of the deities? They are like the plumes on the peacock. Peacock feather is there, there are plumes on it, the eyes. Are those eyes of any use? Maybe it is giving beauty, the eyes are beautifying our face probably. If our eyes are, we are blind, probably it's not so beautiful as we are with eyes. But if the eyes of a peacock feather, he cannot give any indication of the danger coming from other directions, isn't it? Can the peacock feather, the eyes on the plumes on the peacock feather, can it see danger? No. Can it see anything, the food? Oh, if food is available there, nothing. It is useless. Maybe for others, oh, very nice. But for the peacock, useless. In a similar way, eyes, if they don't see the Supreme Lord, useless. Nose, if it does not smell the, the tulsi or the flower that is offered to Supreme Lord, then it is compared to bellows. You know bellow? The goldsmith or the blacksmith, they has a bellows. They pump air. In the olden days, there are bellows, you know. Or nowadays, we have wheel. In the wheel, the air comes, you know, if you turn the wheel. They are called bellows. You don't know bellow? Bellow is, it's basically, let's say, you have an air pillow. You have an air pillow. Do you have an air pillow? Pillow in which there is air. Have an air pillow? You have? Press it. Air will come out. Leave it. Air will get in. So press it. Air telling nose is like that. Only acting like that. Air is getting in, coming out. Useless. Nishprana. Lifeless. Those ears in which Lord's Harikatha does not enter is saying like a serpent's hole. You know the serpent's hole? Serpent in which the serpent goes? The snake? Snake hole? You know snake hole? In the snake hole, what goes? Snake goes. Snake means what? Poison. Those ears in which Lord's Harikatha does not enter, it is like a snake's hole. It's a place of poison. Means all the material stuff is entering inside. What it is? Vishaya is like wish. Wish, you understand? Wish poison. Vishaya means matter. Material things. Vishaya is wish. Material things are poisonous. So if we don't hear Krishna, we will hear material things, and that is like poison, like a snake's den, snake's house, or snake's, you know, hole. And he further says, that tongue which does not sing the glories of Supreme Lord Shri Krishna is like the tongue of a frog. The frog is making sound, right? Quack, 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 quack. He is always shouting. It's like a frog. Frogs croaking. What does it do? He is inviting death. He is giving address to the snakes. Here I am. Please come and eat. Isn't it? Oh, these frogs are eaten by the snakes. So by the croaking, he thinks that he is doing a great job. He is inviting his female partner. But actually he is inviting snakes also. Come, I am here. Please come and eat me. So it is like the croaking of the frogs. Useless. Waste of time. And that head, even though it is nicely decorated with a turban, beautiful, in a crown, you are a prince or a princess, and nicely decorated with a beautiful crown and a turban, but that head which does not fall at the feet of Mukunda or Achyuta, is like, that turban is like a burden on the head only. That turban is not decoration to the head, but it's a burden on the head. So the point is that if the senses are not utilized in the service of Supreme Lord Shri Krishna, then it is useless. Therefore, a devotee, he knows the objective of life. My objective is not to perform karmakanda activities. My objective is to serve Rishikesh, as the master of the senses. Rishikesh means he who is the master of the senses. That is my objective. He is firmly fixed in this knowledge, and therefore, sevai niyukto hoya kono prakar asad vicharer anugaman kurenna. Therefore, he never hankers for anything temporary. A devotee. Whereas a non-devotee, he thinks about how I can be happy now and how I can be happy in the next life. But he cannot think about the permanent happiness. Only pure devotees, sadhus, they can think like that. So this is what, you know, we'll read from tomorrow how a python or a cobra is very happy in all conditions, not hankering for any happiness. When it comes, he is accepting. Doesn't come, not accepting. So this is what we have to learn from a cobra. Vancha kalpatarubhyash kripa sindubhyam patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo.